active basis. So we've talked about Tom in detail today. I'm asking you now to find your Toms. As a Tom myself, it's kind of like the water law that's been described. The way we act and think is like this. We have a full glass of water. And what happens is this water represents all the issues we're trying to deal with. As practice owners, you'll know this. These are all the issues, and we try and deal with it by ourselves, and we hold this up indefinitely. And at the start, it's okay. It's not that heavy. We can handle this. But the longer it goes on without anyone supporting this arm of mine, supporting these issues that we're trying to take care of, the glass gets that little bit fuller. It starts to shake a little bit. And if we were still here tomorrow, it would be down here and shaking tremendously. And we need help. We need support. And if we do not get that support, then the basis of a really good business is going to go all the way down until this is eventually dropped and smashed. The beauty of the people in this room is that they are the supportive hand to hold the Toms of this world and their glasses of water up. So now is the time, as in the conclusion of this conference, to go and act on finding our Toms, picking the phone up and saying, hey, can we talk? So many firms say, I don't know what to say. My advice is start with hi. If that works, go with how are you after that. And we should be all right. And then improvise from there. You'll be okay. Because now is the time to help them. It is too late to help this man. This man, in 1976, was earning today's equivalent of £150,000 a year. He did very, very well for a long time. However, unfortunately, he did not receive support, especially not in those days, of a business advisory nature from anybody. That's not the accountant's fault. There was no such thing around at that time. But this was our original Tom. He was growth, he was ambitious, he was profitable. But it got harder for him. The market got tougher, competition got tighter, and it just got worse and worse and worse. And over time, he lost confidence in himself. And the business went through a downward spiral until its collapse. He continued to try lots of different things, being a family man, and trying to dig himself out of an issue, but unfortunately, he just incurred further and further debt. He tried, unfortunately, got involved in multi-level marketing, and that really wasn't a good idea, and the money that had been accumulated over the years was squandered away until, unfortunately, alcoholism took hold, and his ability to be the charming, erudite individual that he always was also deserted him. This is a man who took on his last job, a commission-only job, at age 54 in 1993, selling hearing aids. It failed also, and a retreat to his room and a downward spiral until his demise nearly 4 years ago. This was our original Tom. This is also my father. And I get my aspirational nature from him. I do the whole tie that matches the cufflinks, that matches the handkerchief, because of him. That's him you're seeing there. That's my ongoing tribute. And he had so much to give that an advisor would have had a fantastic time developing with him. And I was trying to meet his standards to the point where nearly 4 years after his passing, I'm still trying to impress the guy. He would have been very critical of today's performance. But that's a Tom we can't help. We have on our lists now many, many Toms that we can help, including people like me. I advise you, I encourage you, and I look forward to hearing about how you've gone ahead and done exactly that to make your business and our business into something that improves lives. Thank you very much for your time. Cheers.